What's good, everybody? Welcome back to The Last Watch Along. We are looking at the finale of The Boys Season 3. It's been a wild ride. It's probably one of my favorite shows that I've watched here in 2022. There's been a lot of great content that's been released over the summer, but The Boys is absolutely top of the list. I enjoyed it. We got to this point way too soon. Let's go ahead and look at that finale, react to everything that we see, share our thoughts there at the end. Reminding people to subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, because we do watch alongs for a lot of different shows. I would love it for you to come back and check out more episodes right along with me. Without further ado, let's go ahead and take a look at it. And we open with Ryan. Okay. You could kill somebody with one of those. That's different. That's not happening. I remember I made a prediction. I said, wait a minute, that's a CPAP mask because I wear that. That's horrible. But I made a prediction that Soulja Boy is going to be taken out by Noir and Homelander is going to make it. Ooh-wee. Crazy to see this. So this is his way of like doing the right thing, huh? So that's Butcher's way of being doing right by Huey. Punching him. It was funny at first, but I guess that's kind of what he deserved, I guess. This feels unwarranted. I don't like this. He finna renege on that. He gonna let his guard down. Noir gonna kill him.
Like
What are we doing here? What are we doing? Y'all ruined everything that I was thinking. Oh, I'm so upset. What is going on?
That's it, whatever it takes.
What is going on? Well, I don't know what the hell is gonna happen.
Think about this power for a pass. Most of them were nearly dead. They owed you their lives. Not that easy. Boys here, they're the real. What the Jerry's dead here is a bad problem. For sure. Scotch turf.
I was not expecting this. What the hell? Ooh, we. What is that calling him? This is not what I expected. Get me to the fight, man. I don't care right now. That boy gonna be fine.
Hey, asshole.
This is not the fight I wanted.
Terrorist threat called into the building. Please leave as quickly as you can. This is not a drill. This is not a test.
Where are you going, Ashley?
With you, Ashley. To the helipad?
Yeah. So the Sikorsky is actually reserved for SVPs and higher.
Sorry, Ashley.
Thank you.
All right, baby, all right. Come on, come on, Huey. Find another way, better way, okay. About to float. There we go. She can't kill him, though. You. This is interesting. So weird to put in like a memorial like that. Let's go. Let's go. Oh, and he brought her back.
Right.
Wow. Wow. Todd. Perfect face to close on. Oh, man. Wow. What a damn ending, man. I'll say this. At one point in the episode, it seemed like they was wrapping up storylines and, like, wrapping up character arcs. I didn't care for Frenchie one, man. Like Kimiko talking him down from the drugs is like, that was it. Like, that was the culmination of all the stuff you went through with Little Nina and the Russians and the chick from the park and all that stuff. I didn't care for that wrap-up. But every other wrap-up to every other storyline, I was very happy with. Very happy with the fights that we got. Very disappointed that I was so wrong, because I was so confident that Noir would have a role to play in that final fight. Shocked and surprised that Homelander can see Noir's face through the mask, and like that was just never explored up until that very moment. We knew he could hear. We knew he could see with the laser eyes. You know, that was the extent of what we thought. Or at least for me, as the extent of what I thought. But Homelander, in every sense of being, is sicko Superman. Like, not even Bizarro. Like, actually the sickest, darkest version of Superman. So he can see through things, too. I did not know that. I was very disappointed to see Noir. Shocked and disappointed to see Noir go out the way he went out. He had a good build-up, and I was shocked and just disappointed, saddened that he went out that way. But a real solid finale, giving you a good jumping off point for at least one more season, because Leon Butcher's going to die unless they just extend these next 18 months forever in terms of the show, because they can do that. You know, we don't even know how much time passed during these 8 episodes. It feels like maybe 3 weeks of show that we saw, but it could be more. Time has passed, and I imagine they could give us a whole season that takes place in the course of a week, and we can get multiple seasons out of Butcher still with a death diagnosis on him. So who knows what we end up getting. I just know that I enjoyed it. I enjoyed doing the watch-alongs, getting the live reactions for the entire episode. That thing was very good, man. It was very good. Again, probably the best show that I watched this summer. Anyway, what was your favorite moment from this episode, from this finale? Because favorite moment would probably have to be MM. Seeing MM get his, like, that was the moment where I was like, yes. I was very happy to see the way MM's storyline wrapped up. That was probably the peak happiness, and all the fighting and stuff was cool. But yeah, it's the MM moment. It's probably the best moment. See him reconcile with his daughter and embrace the, you know, this is all of me. So cool stuff. Let me know what was your favorite in the comment section. Enjoy yourself, guard your heart, and go watch something good.